So good morning students, today we will discuss about the topic resultant force. We can find out resultant force by various methods. One is a graphical method, another one is your analytical method. So analytical method you can find out resultant by resolution method. First of all, so good morning students, today we will discuss in this lecture resultant, how to find the resultant by resolution method. Then we will move to Lamy's theorem and then we will move to free body diagram. So let us start with first topic, that is resultant by resolution method. Now before starting this, you must know what we mean by resolution. Resolution is what? Divide the force into two components. One is along x-axis and other one is along y-axis. Suppose this one is my force F. So you will have to divide this by these components. Suppose this is the angle theta and this will be my F cos of theta and this will be my F sine of theta. You know in the previous lecture that how to resolve this. Now, what is the formula for to find out resultant? The various steps are, steps number one, you will have to find out all algebraic sum of the all horizontal components. Then second step, you will have to find out the algebraic sum of all vertical components. Then to find out the resultant R, the formula will be summation of Fy square plus summation of Fx square. So from this you can easily find out the magnitude of a resultant force. Now you have already found out the magnitude, the how to find out the direction of the resultant force. And for that the formula is alpha equals to tan inverse mod of summation of Fy upon summation of Fx. So how it comes? As we know that this one is my resultant R and there are two components. This one is Rx and this one is Ry. Here I represent this Rx by summation of Fx and this is summation of Fy. If this one is summation of Fy, I can also write this as summation of Fy and this is angle. If I represent this triangle ABC, then according to your Pythagoras theorem, the AC square must be equals to AB square plus BC square. Here, this AC is nothing but your R. It is equals to root under this square plus this square. That is a AB square plus BC square. So hence, summation of Fy square plus summation of Fx square. Now, from this angle, what is tan alpha? Tan alpha is equals to perpendicular to the base. What is perpendicular? This is BC upon AB. So, mod of summation of Fy upon summation of Fx. Let us take an example. Suppose, I will have to find out the resultant of this. 3 kN at an angle of 30 degree. This one is 2.24 kN. This one is 2 kN at an angle of 60 degree. And 3.9 kN. So for this, it is given as 1, 2. And for this, it is given as 5 and 12. So this is 1 and 2. You can easily find out the angle here. And this is 5 and 12. You can easily find out angle here. So from this, suppose this one is theta 2 and this one is theta 1. How can we find out? So first of all, the first step is to find out theta 1 and theta 2. So for theta 1, theta 1 equals to cos inverse of 1 upon 2. So this is equal to nothing but your 60 degree. This is. Okay. Now, for theta 2, this is equals to. Sorry. Okay. So we will take one problem. This is a problem given to you. 3 kN, 2.24 kN, 2 kN, and 3.9 kN. These are angles given 30 degree and 60 degree. For this angle, it is given 1 by 2. And for this angle, it is given 5 by 12. So this is my, suppose, theta 1. So how can I find out theta 1? As from this angle, tan theta will be equal to 1 upon 2. So I can find out theta 1 like this, tan inverse 1 by 2. That is nothing but 26.56 degrees. And suppose this one is my theta 2. Then the same way, theta 2 equals to 10 inverse 5 by 2, that is 22.62 degrees. So here, I am just writing theta 1 equals to 26.56 degrees. And theta 2, this is equals to 22.62 degrees. Now, the first step is to find out the summation of fx. So we are taking right hand side forces as positive, that's why we have taken positive sign here. Now, resolve these parts. So this will be my 3 cos of 30, this will be my 3 sine of 30. Similarly, this will be 2.24 sine of theta 1, 2.24 cos of theta 1. Since this one is theta 1, that's why this component will become the cos form. For this is 60 degree, 2 newton is 2 cos of 60 degrees, and this is 2 sine of 60 degrees. For this, one component, horizontal component will be this one, vertical component will be this one. This is 3.9 sine of, since the angle is with the vertical, that's why this will come sine component. So 3.9 sine of theta 2, and this will come 3.9 sine of, sorry, it is 3.9 cos of theta 2. Now, summation of fx. Keeping right word positive, so you will have to mention the sign that I am taking, or right hand force as positive. So this will be 3 cos of 30 plus, this is in this direction, so that is minus 2.24 cos of theta 1. What is theta 1? We have already calculated 26.56 degree. So 26.56, then this one, it is in this direction, so again negative 2 cos of 60. Then this one, it is in this direction, so we have taken this as positive. So positive 3.9 sine of theta 2. What is theta 2? We have calculated 22.60. If I solve this, I will get this as 1.0. I have already calculated this one, that's why I am just writing the answer here, 1.094 kN. Now, next step is to find out the all summation of all vertical forces. So here I am assuming that all forces which are being upward, I will be positive. We will start with this one, it is positive. So this will be upper direction, 3 sine of 60. For this, it is again in upper direction plus 2.24 sine of theta 1. What is theta 1? It is 26.56. This is in the downward direction, that is my negative. So negative 2 sine of 60. It is again in this direction. So minus 3.9 cos of theta 2 is 22.62. 22.62. I have already solved this. So the result which I get is negative 2.83 kN. So this one is my value of summation of fx. This one is my value of summation of fy. Now, what is my purpose to solve to find out the resultant? So r will be equals to under summation of fx square plus summation of fy square. What is fx? It is nothing but it is equals to 1.094 square plus minus 2.83 square. So this I will get, I have already calculated this. So this is 3.034 kilonewton. Means the part A of the problem is solved. Okay, so we have found out the magnitude of the resultant. Now what is next thing? The direction. Direction means the angle. So for this, the formula is alpha equals to tan inverse mod of summation of fy upon summation of fx. So this is equals to tan inverse summation of fy. It is minus 2.83, but since it is a mod, so I can take 2.83 divided by fx is 1.094. So I have already calculated this. So this is my 68.86 degrees. Okay. Now the third one is to how to represent. So there is a method to represent. So for this, you must know this thing: summation of fy, summation of fx, and representation. You must remember this table. If summation of fy is positive, summation of fx is also positive, so it will lie in the first quadrant. So it will be like this. That this is summation of fx, this one is summation of fy, and this will be r, and this is angle alpha. Remember one thing, that alpha will be always the angle of resultant with horizontal only. Now suppose if fy is negative, or I can say fx is negative and fy is positive, it will lie in your second quadrant. So fx is negative, fy is positive. So here is r and this is alpha. If both are negative, definitely it will lie in the third quadrant. Like this. This is summation of fy. This is summation of fx. And this is r. What is alpha? Alpha is again the angle of resultant with your horizontal. This is alpha. And suppose the positive negative, now again this is negative and this is positive, means fx is positive. Positive, negative. So if fy is negative and fx is positive, it will lie in your fourth quadrant. This is my resultant r, alpha. So in our case, the value of r we have already find out. Now what about the value of summation of fx and summation of fy, which we have already calculated? Fx is positive 1.9094 kilonewton and fy is negative 2.83 kilonewton, and the value of r was 3.034. So how will we represent this? It is positive, it is negative. So this one is positive and fy is negative, so it will lie in your fourth quadrant. So here summation of fx, this will be equals to 1.094 kilonewton. This is 2.83 kilonewton. This is r and this one is alpha. which is nothing but equals to, you know what, 68.86. Now in a problem, suppose they ask you what is the magnitude and direction of equilibrium force. What is equilibrium force? That is collinear with resultant. Equal in magnitude but in opposite direction. So this will be my Re and this is alpha. Now if they ask you what is the value with the base horizontal, then for that this will be the angle made by resultant. Okay, and for equilibrium this is the angle made by equilibrium. I hope you understand how to calculate the resultant force of a concurrent force system. Okay, let us take one more example. It is given, I am just reading out the problem. A particle position at point O, suppose this is my point O, they are giving, is acted upon three forces as shown in figure. So this is the figure given to you. This is 20 kilometer. This one is P. This is in this direction and 30 kilometer. The angles are 15 degree here, 45 degree here, and this is the angle 30 degree. What they ask, find out the value of force P. What will be this, the value of force P? The condition is given that the resultant of this is represented by horizontal direction, means whatever R is horizontal. What is the value of R? R equals to root under F x square and summation of F y square. If R is horizontal, means I will get only horizontal component. The vertical component will be 0. Summation of F y will be equals to 0. So this is the first condition. Suppose in this problem, it is given as that your resultant is represented by vertical. In that case, what will happen? Instead of Fy, summation of Fx will be 0. So if we calculate this, so first we find out summation of all vertical forces. Okay, we know as per our problem this equals to 0. What is summation of Fy? Divide this, the various part. So definitely this will come 20 cos of 50. This is P cos of, what is 45 plus 50? That is 60. P cos of 60. This is P sine of 60. This is 20 cos 15. This is 20 sine of 15. And it must be the force was 30. So this will be 30 cos of 30 and 30 sine of 30. So for vertical, it's 20 sine of 50 plus P sine of 60. This is in the downward direction, it will come minus 30. Sine of 30 equals to 0. So from here I can calculate P. I have already calculated P. So this will come 11.34 Newton. This is the answer. Now, what will be the resultant? We know that R square equals to summation of Fx square plus summation of Fy square. But according to the condition of your question, this is 0. So R square equals to summation of Fx. So R will be equals to summation of fx only, which is equals to 20 cos of 15 plus P cos of 60 and this plus 30 cos of 30. Now you know the value of P, 11.34. So this will come, I have calculated this one, 50.97. How will I represent? I will represent it by, since there is no summation of fy. So 50.97, it is positive one, that's why this is my resultant, R equals to 50.97. And about the equilibrium, this is R equals to 50.97 R suffix E. So this is your equilibrium force and this one is your resultant force. So this is how we find out the resultant of a concurrent force system. Thank you. So by the ending of this lecture, you must be know about the method to find out resultant of concurrent coplanar force system, that is R equals to under root of summation of all horizontal components square plus summation of or vertical component square. Then about the direction, that is alpha, it is the angle made by this resultant always with your horizontal. Alpha equals to tan inverse mod of summation of fy upon summation of fx. We have done this, we have done this. And how to locate, this is summation fx, summation of fy, summation of fx, summation of fy. If fx is positive and fy is positive, then the resultant will lie in first quadrant. Alpha is the angle. If summation fx is negative and fy is positive, it will lie, resultant will lie in second quadrant. If fx is negative and fy means both are negative, then it will lie in the third quadrant. And if fx is positive and fy is negative, then it will lie in the fourth quadrant. Okay, but some of the students may confuse between some query how to resolve. So for this, you can do one thing. Suppose this is P1, P2, P3, P4, in the same sense, P1, P2, P3, P4. Here, all forces are tensile one, and here, all forces are compressive one. Suppose this is angle alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, and alpha 4. And how will we resolve this? The horizontal component will move towards right, vertical component will move towards up. So this will be my P1 cos of alpha 1, and this is my P1 sine of alpha 1. And suppose instead of alpha 1, we take the angle theta 1. In that case, the theta 1 is the angle made with your vertical component. So in this case, it will become P1 cos of theta 1, and this will become P1 sine of theta 1, and the remaining are like this. So this will be my P2 cos of alpha 2, P2 sine of alpha 2, P2 cos of alpha 2. And in the same sense, if this is P1 is here towards the point, then the component will be like this. Okay? Again, suppose this one is your alpha 1, then this will be my P1 cos of alpha 1, this will be my P1 sine of alpha 1, and if this is theta 1, then in this case, this will become P1 sine of theta 1, this will become P1 cos of theta 1. So, in the sense, if I take only alpha, then this is cos alpha 2, this is P3 cos of alpha 3, P3 sine of alpha 3, it will be like this. So, P4 cos of alpha 4, P4 sine of alpha 4, and for this one, if I write summation of alpha 5, this will be, I am considering only alpha 1. So, P1 cos of alpha 1, this side is minus P2 cos of alpha 2, it will in this direction minus P3 cos of alpha 3, and this is plus P4 cos of alpha 4. And sorry, this is your summation of Fx, all horizontal. And for all vertical forces, summation of Fy, upward positive, this will be my P1 sine of alpha 1 plus P2 sine of alpha 2 minus P3 sine of alpha 3 minus P4 sine of alpha 4. This is for this diagram. For second one, it is P1 sine, if I consider only alpha 1, P1 sine alpha 1, P1 cos alpha 1, for this, this is your horizontal, so this is P2, sorry, alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha 4. So this will be P2 cos of alpha 2, P2 sine of alpha 2, for this, this is the direction, P3 cos of alpha 3, P3 sine of alpha 3, for this, it is upward, this one is downward. So P4 cos of alpha 4, P4 sine of alpha 4. For this one, I am writing here the summation of Fy. This will become, it is minus P1 sine of cos of alpha 1. Here, since it is in this direction, that's why we have written P1 cos of alpha 1. But in this, since it is in the leftward direction, minus P1 cos of alpha 1, then plus P2 cos of alpha 2, then this is in this direction, so plus P3 cos of alpha 3, and this is in this direction, so minus P4 cos of alpha 4. Similarly, for F1, this will be equals to, this is in the downward direction, so minus P1 sine of alpha 1. In the previous formula, this was in upward direction, that's why we have taken P1 sine of alpha 1. And here it is minus P1 sine of alpha 1 minus P2 sine of alpha 2 plus P3 sine of alpha 3 plus P4 sine of alpha 4. So I hope you are now clearly understood how to find out summation Fx and summation Fy. Are you ready? Thank you.